Good morning, this is Dave Herman, alias Daz the Artist, on May 30th, 2017 at 11:26 in the morning. For 10 minutes I'm going to try and do a Sumai-e painting of a monkey's head. Let's see how that works. So, let's roughly do the shape of the head. And since it's a monkey, it's a little more elongated. And let's start with the ear. And we'll make some shapes. And we're going to do this as Sumai-e, so as soon as I get it recognizable, I can do some of those strokes, but right now this is like a sketching to get us into the shapes and the proper proportions, pretty much, of the monkey. So, just kind of shaping up here stuff. Some direction with the eyes and monkey nose kind of would be out here. So we're just kind of sketching it in right now, just doing a little doodle, and hopefully we'll turn it into something in 10 minutes. It's not much time, but I'm only going to do 10 minutes. And try and have some character. And a little high brow. It's a little bit smaller, a little more defined. And this one over here a little bigger. A little more defined. And then kind of come down like this. Kind of make the muzzle, the face, you see, look kind of puffy, and its beard here and some hair. Then the head kind of comes back like so, and a smaller mouth and chin like this, and some hair, and kimono. Give him a little kimono. And now we'll, let's see, give him an arm maybe going up in the air. We're not going to be able to develop, but it gives us something else in this picture. And now we can try and work up the hair. So let's pick a brush 8. And let's see the texture, say bristles, too much bristle there. We want to be smaller bristle size, but so many. In fact, we're going to go to brush 2, I think. And in brush 2, we have 100% bristles. I want to take that down to like 50-ish, 40-ish. And the bristle size, pretty small. And then try some hairs. Okay. And we're going to start to draw our monkey. And now I'm going to kind of define it out with some strokes and then some grays and stuff. So let's first go back to brush 9. And let's do some pressure sensitive strokes. Maybe like that. And maybe like that. As we try and do a little summary painting. Of the happy monkey. And this is can be covered up with some grays. I think I'm going to do some gray strokes. So let's see how that comes out. And, you know, this could cut off in about a minute. So let's get a little bit more in there, and it's just going to be a cool sketch. So jumping back and forth always digitally, you can't go quite as fast, but you can see that we're making up something very cool here. And it can give you the semi look with the number 9 brush. The Philosopher Monkey by Daz. Who would have thought you could do this digitally, huh? It appears you can do anything you want digitally. You just have to find the right brush and spend the right amount of time doing your due diligence, getting the skills. Totally looks like actual brushwork. I am amazed by the beauty of this thing on a digital painting. And you can take it even further and further and add highlights and many things that you can do traditionally. Give him some long lashes like a wise man. Very, very cool. Digging it totally. The Philosopher Monkey King